So first question is, have you got a favourite building or a man-made structure that you think enhances the town, and or something that, you know, just you think is really attractive, and what it is you like about it?
Yep, so my favourite building is in my favourite park, and that's in the Kay Park. I absolutely love the Burns Monument Centre, and I love it so much because I knew it when it was just a tower. When I started here back in 1992, we used to run Burns Day celebrations, and I was the sports officer, and I did all the events, and one of my jobs was to hoover that tower from top to bottom because people used it once a year. I love the beautiful sandstone nature of it. I think it's a beautiful tower. It stands out. I'm not a mad person that's into poetry, but I think it stands out. And you can see it from all different parts of Kilmarnock when you're driving in. You see it popping its head over. And I was heartbroken when there was the fire there. We really were. And we thought, was that going to be the end of a monument that, to me, sat so well within the surroundings of the park? But out of the phoenix, or out of the flame came the phoenix, out of suffering came hope, because we were able to use the money from the insurance, but also to work in a really creative way with a number of people at the time to develop the centre round about it. And it was a colleague of mine, Gerard Cairns, who's now retired, who was in charge of libraries at the time and registration. And he had a dream with his staff to really make that an amazing place for people to get married and to go and research genealogy. So for me, it was about somebody having a dream based on, you know, something that had been destructed. You know, there was a destruction, and that we grew the sandstone building round the tower out of it, redid the tower, but kept it and keep it. It wasn't too modern, but it had a modern enough flair that you could go and have a wedding there. So also it brought people to the park who had never been. And the Kay Park is probably the treasure for me in Kilmarnock. So I love that monument centre. I've had happy experiences there. I was interviewed to be the kind of head of housing there, and I was also interviewed for my post of deputy chief executive. And so I've got good memories of wanting to put myself in there and going into my most beautiful park and being comfortable to be there. So that building's beautiful, and it came out of a fire and was made into something hopeful and useful that people use from all over the world now in terms of genealogy and get married. Yeah.
Yeah. My sister did her research into her family tree a few years ago. So I went out with her there, and I was quite impressed by all the resources and the documents that were there. We even got a wee look in the archive bit. And the chap brought out this document, and I can't remember what it was, but it was like something that was like over 200 years old, you know, and I'm thinking, oh, that would have been about the time of the French Revolution and things like that. And here it was, you know, a document sitting in a store in Kilmarnock. So it's that connection back with the past, isn't it? And even like you're saying, the modern function, that the function room is lovely when you're sitting in it and you can look out into the park with the long windows at the side of it.
No, it's a great building, and you know, you're so right about the connection with history, you know, that you know, and they built it in such a way that although it looks traditional outside, those documents, that it's air protected. So they built amazing things inside to keep our heritage safe. And yeah. I think that was so important. And the other thing that reminds me of up there is Cathy Dunlop and her team, who's a chief registrar for the council. You know, she registers death, she carries out manages with her team. And just recently, and I know I'm going off script a wee bit, but you'll expect that from me.
No, that's what it's all about.
But, you know, just recently, you know, they've been working every weekend since this started, because obviously we need to register deaths over the weekend. So they've been, you know, quietly working away. And recently they carried out a wedding. Somebody had asked them to, that somebody was terminally ill and they wanted to get married. And they found a way to make it happen. You know, Cathy, for me, epitomises, you know, what a flexible, you know, person, a servant leader is in terms of, you know, she's in that surrounding. She absolutely loves it. She makes the very best of it. But also she serves people from there and reaches out from there as well. So there's a people feel to me about that building, and there's the building itself, which is just steeped in history that will be preserved for us. So
there's definitely something about your work environment and how it gets the best out of people and how it's good absolutely for their well-being as well. So.